Hey guys, what's up? We're gonna install Visual Studio's code today, or VS Code. As they describe it, it's a very lightweight and powerful like open source editor. It runs on your desktop and you can, you know, support multiple languages and scripting languages and extensions. And it's like a pretty amazing ecosystem that you get for free. So we're gonna go about just trying to install it here on the Mac, and I'm using the M1 Silicon Mac, so we're going to do it this way. And we're going to search for a browser. First off, we're going to use Safari, and we're just going to enter that. And then we're going to search for VS Code, and here's a suggested website. We're going to click on that. This brings up the website for Visual Studio's Code. As of this recording, looks like the stable version is 1.63. So if you come here for the first time, you can just grab this stable build and download it and just install as, you know, as the instructions state. So it was pretty self-explanatory. You can check out the site, the blog, and all those things. But I'm going to scroll down to the bottom here, and I'm going to pick a specific build. I'm going to take the Apple Silicon build here. Okay, this takes you to the download link, and it'll start downloading. And depending on the speed of your machine and your internet, it should be done fairly quickly. Give it a minute or so. Once that's done, we'll just quit Safari. Depending where you set up your downloads to go, it might be your downloads directory or, I don't know, your desktop. In my case, it's my desktop. We're just going to open up Spotlight using Command Space, and I'm going to just open up Finder. And in my case, it's on my local desktop. So here's the program that I downloaded from our browser using Safari, and it's VS Code. So if you were to double-click on this, it would open up and start the application. If you want this inside of your applications directory, so it would be like users, you know, applications, you just take this file and drag it into that folder. I won't show you how to do that, but, you know, you'll get that. It's pretty straightforward. So we'll double-click this, and it will open up an instance or a copy of the program. So what we want to do next is we would like to hit Command Shift P, and that will bring up the shell command. If we start typing in shell, command. And what we want to do is we want to install VS Code to this path. So I've already done this, so I'm not going to do this, but if you double click this, it'll get installed to your path. And then in anywhere inside of, say, an emulator like terminal, you can call code and, you know, open up a document or a file or something, other than using another type of editor. So that's done there. We'll quit this and we will then open up terminal. So I'm going to use once again Spotlight. Now that terminal's open, if you wanted to see a file, you would normally, let's say, use the editor built into terminal. You might type in something like Nano, and then perhaps you might just type in the tilde dot the zshrc file. Sorry, I missed the, there we go. RC file, and then it would open up this document or this file, and you would see what's currently inside of that file. And in my case, I have a few things kind of in here already. That's one way to do it, but you know, if you haven't used Nano before and you're not familiar with using it as a beginner, it might be a little bit intimidating. So we'll just close this right now by hitting Control X and we'll quit. Now we can do the exact same thing using Visual Studio's Code or VS Code. So you would just type in code and we will repeat the same command, and that would be the tilde sign forward slash, and we would use the .zshrc file. And as you can see, the same thing will open up inside of VS Code, and it's a little bit more intuitive and you can get around and you can manage it, you know, a little bit easier than say Nano. So future content on this channel, depending on what I want to do, I will open up files this way by typing in code and then just trying to see this, depending what we're doing. Okay, so that's all you need to know for this video. I'll just close this stuff up. You can check this out if you want to. It's just, we're in restricted mode right now. You can just trust the developers and all the other things, and you can do that at your leisure. I'll just close this up for now. And I will also quit this, quit terminal. And finally, I will close Finder. Okay, that's it. I hope you guys found that useful. And that's how I'm installing Visual Studio's Code for all the things that we're going to do moving forward. There'll be other editors. There's Sublime. There's Atom. You know, later on, I'll be using some paid editors, but these open source editors are really good. And it's a great ecosystem for you to get started with. All right, I'll see you guys in the next one.